I'm Nipun Malhotra. I started the Nipman Foundation in 2012 along with my mother Priyanka Malhotra. The reason why I really started the Nipman Foundation was the kind of discrimination that I saw persons with disabilities face firsthand. When I was doing my master's in economics from Delhi School of Economics, I decided to sit for placements. And when I was applying for jobs, I saw the kind of discrimination persons with disabilities face. Because whenever I entered an interview, it was not Nipun Malhotra that the HR started looking at, but just the person on a wheelchair. There was one HR person who asked me whether I can sit on a wheelchair for 8 hours a day, and I actually wanted to test that. There was another who asked me, a master's student, whether I've ever read a book. There was a third that eventually rejected me because they did not have a disability-friendly toilet. And when I told them that I can control my bladder, they said, no, we fear that you might sue us tomorrow, so it's just safer not to hire you. So companies kept coming up with such flimsy excuses, you know, and I was humiliated. I had lost complete confidence. I locked myself in my room for a month or so. But it was then that I realized I was much luckier because my parents had given me a completely normal life. And I felt, what about the other Nipuns like me who have not got the opportunities that I've got? And that's when I decided to start the Nipman Foundation along with my mother to empower persons with disabilities in this country and ensure that they do not face the kind of discrimination that I did. The initial focus was more of inclusion of persons with disabilities in the corporate sector, because that's a challenge I'd faced and I wanted to resolve that challenge. We did a lot of accessibility audits with a wide variety of companies. We helped them identify roles where persons with disabilities can be employed. What changed the direction of Nipman Foundation was an incident in 6th March 2015. Yeah, I was entering a restaurant. And the restaurant denied entry to me because they said that as a policy, we don't allow people with disabilities inside. I was, of course, felt humiliated. My wheelchair was pushed back and manhandled by the restaurant staff. And in an indignant rage, I shared this on social media platforms, including Facebook. And before I knew it, this post started getting shared all across the country. There were hundreds of shares. I think social media has been an extremely important platform in my journey, both as a disability rights activist and as the CEO of Nipman Foundation. And by social media, I mean platforms like Facebook that help amplify the message. A platform like Facebook is going to provide three kinds of advantages to an organization like Nipman Foundation. A, it's going to help you in advocacy by helping unite people around you towards a social cause that you are really fighting for. B, it's going to help sensitize citizens of the country and the world on the needs of a particular cause that you're fighting for, which is disability in the case of Nipman Foundation. And C, it's going to help you identify both donors and beneficiaries. For example, one of our projects called Wheels for Life, which is really a crowdfunding platform through which we connect people who need wheelchairs to people who can donate wheelchairs. It's really a simple model where anybody can donate 5,000 rupees through Facebook and its sister organization Instagram. We've managed creating a couple of campaigns to promote this, including one of the campaigns that we recently did was 100 Days, 100 Stories, through which we kind of showed case studies of people whose life have been impacted. And when people read these case studies, they of course got more motivated to donate, because what they realized, for them 5,000 rupees doesn't really mean that much. It perhaps means one fancy meal at a restaurant, a pair of jeans, or their favorite shirt. But the same 5,000 rupees can impact somebody's life. Through a wheelchair, it can help a child go back to school. It can help an adult take up a job, or it can even mean somebody exiting their house for the first time in decades and seeing sunrise.
Facebook has been a very useful tool because we could spread the message far to people who are interested and could see the actual feel of a life transforming. So I keep posting and sharing whatever activities we do, and a lot of people send back messages. They want to connect and they want to contribute and help us reach our mission.
I think I had an excellent experience at the Facebook NGO Day last year. I managed interacting with a lot of young NGOs and sharing how we've used Facebook as a platform to spread a message. I also got to hear from a lot of larger NGOs that are older than us and realize that it's a continuous learning process and how we can improve even further. targeting a specific audience is something which is very useful. Mainstream media does not really give you the option of targeting specific groups, and I think that is something that something like Facebook does. And I think in the coming future, it's going to be used much more by non-profits and development sector organizations in pushing their message across.